Hello, everybody, and welcome to Units 5 and 6, where the focus is on arguments. Now, by this point in the course, I'm hoping that you recognize that when we use the word argument, we don't mean interpersonal conflict, but we mean something very specific. And the material in these two units is conceptually, I like to say, rich. And so I hope you take your time with it. I recommend with philosophy in general and critical thinking in particular that you, as a rule, walk away every 30 minutes, if not every 20 minutes, give your mind a certain rest. I like going and doing a couple of dishes or putting something in the microwave. And just give myself time to digest what it is I'm trying to understand. So I'm going to run through some of the features of arguments as we will understand them. And the first thing that's worth saying is that an argument consists of premises and a conclusion. And the way that I go about when I'm listening to somebody or reading something or, listening to a long discussion on the radio or, you know, the internet or whatever it might be, what I do is I ask myself, fundamentally, what is this person trying to get me to walk away believing that I may not have otherwise believed? And whatever that is, if I can isolate it, and sometimes there are many things, but if it's simple enough, I can isolate it and say, okay, here is what they want me to believe. And that's the conclusion. And then I ask myself, what is the support that they've offered for that conclusion? And whatever that is, those are the premises. Now, just being human, we can go on and on and say a lot of superfluous things. I probably do that in these videos, right? So I try to hone in, like, what really constitutes an attempt on this person's part to support the conclusion that they've reached. And then I can begin to try to establish an argument structure. So now let me just rattle off, strictly speaking, how things work. An argument is a series of claims, precisely one of which functions as the conclusion, plays the role of the conclusion, and all the others of which are claims that we call premises. So an argument is a series of claims, precisely one of which is the conclusion, and all the others of which are the premises. There are two fundamentally different types of arguments, inductive arguments and deductive arguments. You actually need to ask yourself, does this reasoner or does this argument itself, apart from the reasoner, either way, you can do it either way, does it look like the intention is that if you assume that the premises are true, then the conclusion would also have to be true? And the answer to that question will determine whether or not you regard the argument as deductive or inductive. An inductive argument, I guess I'll start there, is an argument in which, even in the best case scenario, if all the premises are true, the conclusion could still be false. So just to quickly run through a popular example, the sun has risen every day of my life. So therefore, I conclude that the sun will rise tomorrow. You go, well, yeah, everybody knows that the sun will rise tomorrow, and that's not the way to approach this. Ask yourself instead what the premise says. The premise says the sun has risen every day of my life, therefore the sun will rise tomorrow. Is it possible that the sun won't rise tomorrow, given what's said in the premises, not given your background knowledge, because it's not about what you know, it's just look at the premise and look at the conclusion. And even though the sun has risen every day of my life, there is some remote possibility. It doesn't, as it were, force the conclusion that the sun will rise tomorrow. So that's actually an inductive argument. You'll get to practice with this. You need to go through the material, so I won't say more about that now. So a deductive argument, on the other hand, is marked by this feature. If the premises are assumed to be true, not if they are true, but if we assume them to be true, then the conclusion would have to be true as well. So let me give you a silly example very quickly. Hillary Clinton is a tomato. All tomatoes own penthouses in Los Angeles. Therefore, what? See, you could probably say it. So if Hillary Clinton is assumed to be a tomato, and all tomatoes own penthouses in Los Angeles, what would also have to be true? Well, it would have to be true that Hillary Clinton owned a penthouse in Los Angeles. Maybe she really does. I don't know. But I know that she's not really a tomato, and I know that tomatoes don't own penthouses, right? But if those things were true, the conclusion would have to be true. That's a valid argument. That's what a valid argument is. It's weird because we use validity and the word valid to mean something very different in everyday life. I try to explain this all in the units. Okay, so a valid argument is an argument in which if we assume that all the premises are true, the conclusion would have to be true as well. So all inductive arguments, it turns out, are invalid, but that's okay. We just need to learn how to assess for validity because that's part of an argument analysis. And we can do that, and in fact, we do that best when we don't think about our background beliefs, and we don't think about what we know about the world, and we don't think about what other people know or believe or want to be true, or any of that stuff. See, so what we're doing is now we're just isolating language and the world, and we're trying to get away from trying to read other people's minds, trying to, you know, bring in all of the assumptions that we all have when we come into this course, and just look at the language and say, if all these premises were true, would that conclusion have to be true as well? Okay, well, that's probably enough for now, if not too much. So I'm going to stop there. Maybe in Unit 6, I'll put up another video if I get ahead of you enough to do that. The material's all there, but I haven't put up a video there yet, but I'll try to once you've gone through Unit 5. So good luck with this, and you know, it's going to demand some focus, and you'll probably have some questions, and hopefully the discussion that eventually arises will help answer some of those. And remember, you can always talk to me about any of this. Okay, very good. Thank you. Carry on. Best wishes.